Hey there, Maintenance Man fans. I'm going to do a quick video today on how to change a thermostat, a wall thermostat. It's a standard four wire. Usually they have a cover plate that comes off. And what you're going to have is a couple of wires here. Take the terminals loose. You may have a round style thermostat. Still takes four wires. Just loosen all the terminals up you can possibly find. And sometimes whenever you're doing these, you're going to find that there's a front plate that attaches to a rear plate, and there will be some screws that are kind of tucked away and hidden in places that will help you get them off. And what I do is I just take my SOG multi-tool and I dig in there and I get those wires off best I can. And once all those wires are free, just take the thermostat off the wall. And like I said before, if there's a cover plate, you're going to take that off before you can even get to those terminals. You'll have some usually flat blade screwdriver ends that are going to be holding the thing on there in two or three different spots, depending on whether you have White Rogers or some kind of thermostat that's there. And basically, you end up with your four wires. You're going to have a red, you'll have a red, you'll have a white, you'll have a green, and either you'll have a blue or a yellow. I'll tell you in a minute here what to do with that blue or yellow wire. And because I know the style of thermostat I'll be putting on is just a basic digital, it's going to attach to some hubs that have set screws in them. And I know I need shorter leads on there, so I just clipped off the ends of those. Run your wires into whatever hole is on your new thermostat, whether it's a vertical mount or a horizontal mount. Just do that. Let me grab the screws here to attach it to the wall with. I'll get out my screwdriver bit on my multi-tool here. When I'm all done, I'll patch the wall behind it, make everything look pretty, but for the video today, we're just going to stick it in the wall to get it done. Sometimes they come with anchors, and you can use those if you want to, but I find they're completely unnecessary. For the most part, as long as you gently put your screw into your drywall, you shouldn't have any problem with it stripping out. It should hold it firm, and everything should be pretty good. Plus, they give you such long screws, you got a lot of stuff you can go into. You get all the way through the drywall on it, it'll hold down real nice, real tight. Plus, I think I might actually be hitting a stud on this one. And that bottom screw down here. Yeah, sorry about the sparks. I work with them live. They're only 24 volts. It's probably not a good idea to make them spark because you could blow up the transformer, or at least you run a risk of it. But all you really got to do is make sure that when you do this, shut off your furnace at the furnace. There's usually an on-off switch that you can flick off, just kind of like a light switch, right at the furnace, on the side of it, right near it, and then that'll shut off the 24 volts to your thermostat as well. Okay, I have a different multi-tool that I use for these tie-downs here, and you can see, at least on this model here, they have a little guide up here. Y is for yellow, R is for red, C is for common, W is for white, O or B is for orange or blue, which, here's the trick. When you have an older thermostat wire that runs the blue wire in there, the four wire pair, you want to hook the blue to the yellow. And if you have a newer one, a newer style, it's going to be blue to blue, but you'll also have a yellow wire in the pair. So remember, blue to yellow if there's no yellow wire there. And then you go green to green, white to white, red to red. Sometimes you might find some thermostats are going to have a red wire jumper, is what they call it, and it goes in between the red H and the red C, and what that means is red hot for the heater and red C for the cooler, for the air conditioner. And they have to be jumpered between them because it provides the voltage to those two separate systems, depending on what your selector switches are set at. And you just leave that jumper wire there. Don't take it out, don't cut it in two, unless you have some special application where you need to. But I figure if any of you maintenance man fans are in that kind of a situation, you probably already know what you're doing. So I hooked the white up to the W, which is that bottom terminal. I'll hook the red up to the R. And on this one, all of the jumpers are internal to the actual thermostat piece. I just tighten those down. The only reason why I use a different multi-tool is because the screwdriver bit on anything that the SOG has is too big. And if I use the screwdriver bit from my Leatherman, then it fits inside there perfectly. I'm gonna put the green on the green, red on the red, white on the white, and blue goes to the yellow terminal. I tuck my wires in there, as you can kind of see what I've been doing. They get a little tight towards the end, so I kind of start shoving. But if you can just tuck them back in the wall. I kind of use the tip of my multi-tool to persuade them into where they actually need to be. Once you get them all tucked in there, kind of can't see them anymore. End part is the easy part. Now there's, on back here you've got hot gas, hot electric. That's the HG and the HE. There might be something like that. It's just a little pull-off thing you make sure is on the right terminals. They usually come correctly for most gas systems. But basically, there you go. And thanks for watching the maintenance man.